With the help of the Police Athletic Activities League and the Boys and Girls Club of Greater Westfield, the members of our Pal McGruff Club have had the opportunity to make a difference in their community. Over the past year, this club has learned and applied the Pal McGruff curriculum, which includes topics on personal, community, and public safety. The percentage of bullying in America has been on the rise. The members of the BGC Westfield Pal McGruff Club decided they wanted to make a video with real statistics about bullying. Bullying won't go away overnight, but with more kids and adults standing up and speaking out, we can all help make a difference.
More than one out of two students report being bullied, according to stats from the annual bullying survey.
Students who experience bullying are at increased risk for poor school adjustment, sleep difficulties, anxiety, and depression.
So when you do bad things, do you ever feel good about when you just waste time? You have to do good things to make yourself feel good. You can't just say, oh, I'm so angry, why it's not fair, it's not going to make it better. Alright? Your attitude about it is going to make it better. Okay? Then you're going to become someone who can solve problems.
Most bullying takes place in school, outside on school grounds, and on the school bus. Bullying also happens wherever kids gather in the community. And of course, cyberbullying occurs on cell phones and online.
Okay, so where do you see bullying happen the most?
At recess.
A bully is 5 times more likely to have a serious criminal record when you grow up.
Make strong eye contact when you face it. Don't look away, don't look back. Make control and start voice. Tell them that this is not acceptable.
The percentages of individuals who have experienced cyberbullying at some point in their lifetime have nearly doubled, 18% to 34% from 2007 to 2016. Is this really real?
64% of children who were bullied did not report it. Only 36 reported the bullying.
The National Prevention Center reports a 7% increase in reporting bullying cases since the U.S. Department of Education began tracking bullying in 2005.
So what do you think about that?
I think that's really good because 7% is really high.
Yeah, but that means 7%. So that means that bullying has increased, like more bullying has been happening since 2005. So do you think that's a good thing?
I think that's a terrible thing.
Yeah.
Because people shouldn't be bullying.
And you should treat others with respect as well. Just because they annoy you, it doesn't treat you way too well. Bully them back. And when you see someone who is getting bullied, you should what? Stand up for them.
160,000 students stay home every day to avoid bullies.
More than half of the bully situations stop when the three interventions on behalf of the students being bullied.
2/3 of students who are targets of bullying become bullies.
The more you did in the beginning, it's hard. Then it's going to get easier, easier, easier. Then you're going to realize you are more empowered. Because you believe in yourself and you know that you're important. And you get used to doing it. Then the bully's gonna realize, oh, there's something different about that person. It's a lot harder for me to bully.
School-based bullying prevention programs like Pal McGruff decrease bullying by up to 25%.
So do you think that Pal has taught you how to stop the bullies?
Yes.
Among high school students, 15.5% are cyberbullied and 20.2% are bullied on school property. Among middle school students, 24% are cyberbullied and 45% are bullied on school property.
Okay, so after reading that, do you think that you've seen more bullying happen in middle school or high school?
I've seen more bullying happen in middle school.
So, yes, why do you think bullying is bullying? Yes. That's probably one thing, yes. I don't know really how to make friends. That's why you work with people. So,
the reasons for being bullied reported often by students were looks, body shape, and race.
A bully is 6 times more likely to be arrested by the age of 24.
What do you think about that?
I think it's pretty reasonable because they're old enough to go to jail at that age.
Why do you think that they're more likely to be arrested?
Because they're doing stuff that could probably scar kids for almost the rest of their life.
Throughout your life, not just now, you get run over by police, or it could be things that makes you afraid. You can run from those all your life, or you can stand up and learn how to deal with those. Learn how to deal with anger. Learn how to deal with being afraid. Learn how to be grateful, how you be there, what people love, people say. No one has the right to label.
Studies also have shown that adults, including parents, can help prevent bullying by keeping the lines of communication open, talking to their children about bullying, encouraging them to do what they love, modeling kindness and respect, and encouraging them to get help when they are involved in bullying or know others who need help.
Students who experience bullying report that allying and supportive action from their peers, such as spending time with the student, talking to them, helping them get away, or giving advice, were most helpful actions from bystanders.
When bystanders intervene, bullying stops within 10 seconds, 57% of the time.
One of the things that we'd like to touch on, my biggest thing you can ask any of my cadets here is integrity. And that's doing the right thing when nobody's looking. That's the biggest and most number one thing that you guys should remember for the rest of your lives, the word integrity. So when nobody's looking, you're still doing the right thing.
Everyone say, repeat after I say, 감사.
감사.
합니다.